Hi, my name is Pete Hahn, and thank you for watching this tutorial video. Be sure to visit www.hahn-tech.com for the full library of video tutorials. I hope this video increases your knowledge and helps you become more efficient with this topic, whether for home or work. Please support this channel by sharing these videos with your friends and colleagues. Thank you. I'll begin from the Charts tab on the Thinkorswim platform. Notice there are four available views for the Charts tab. We begin with the furthest to the left. I've started with a blank canvas here, and we'll quickly show you how to set up and save a chart layout. I want to make sure you know how to do this before we get into the details. Here I am using the Load Style menu option to quickly configure these charts. I'll do the same for all four chart panes. Now I want to take a few moments to explain the issue this video is going to solve. Just like every other trading platform in the world, Thinkorswim provides the ability to save your chart layouts. Unlike every other trading platform in the world, Thinkorswim does not display the name of the currently selected saved chart layout. This has caused a great deal of frustration and confusion among users of this platform. So right now, I'll save this chart layout by clicking the Chart Grid Selection button. I navigate down the menu and click the Save Grid As. Then I select a name for this chart layout and click the Save button. Now let's take a few moments to search the screen and see exactly where the name of this currently selected chart layout is displayed. I'll keep quiet while you search. Nope, I didn't find it either. It's not there. Clicking again on the Chart Grid Selection button, I can show you the long list of saved chart layouts I have. And there is no way to tell at any given time which of these is being displayed. Next up, I'll demonstrate the same thing in the Flexible Grid view. I access that view by clicking the third button from the left. Just as before, we start off with a blank canvas. I'll turn off the control boxes in the center of each chart pane by clicking the second button from the right, then navigating down to the Customize Grid. Next, I will load a saved style for each chart grid and enter a symbol. This time, I will use a symbol link to ensure all four chart panes have the same symbol. To finish up, I'll update the time frames so that we have a daily and intraday charts of the same symbol displayed together. To save a chart layout in the Flexible Grid view, you click the second button from the right, navigate down to the Save Flexible Grid As, and enter the name. Clicking the Save button adds it to the list of saved flexible grids. Notice I'm using the exact same name for this as the previous example. This is intentionally done to demonstrate a very important fact. What you save in the Flexible Grid view is kept completely separate from what is saved in the Charts view, totally unconnected. However, what they do hold in common is the complete absence of any clue as to which saved chart layout is currently open. Go ahead, take another look. So, it's just not there, and you can see I have a large number of chart layouts saved in the Flexible Grid view. So, now that I've explained the problem, I'm going to close out of this account and log back into Thinkorswim using the Paper Money account. I have much fewer saved chart layouts in the Paper Money side, and it will make the presentation a bit cleaner. Okay, so here I've logged into the Paper Money side of Thinkorswim. The first task is to install the custom study into this account. After installing a custom study, it will be available to add to any of my charts. The name of the file is chartgridnamestudy.ts, and this file is available to download via the link in this video's description. I saved my file to my desktop. When you download it, just be sure to remember where you put it. so that you can navigate to it in the next step. Now, I will go back to the Thinkorswim platform and show you how to install that file. From any open chart pane, click the Studies button and navigate to the menu item Edit Studies. From the next window, look down to the bottom left and find the button labeled Import. Clicking that will open a file search dialog. Navigate to the location you saved that file. In my case, I navigate to the desktop. Once you locate the file, click the Open button and installation of the custom study is complete. Now I will show you how to add this custom study to one of your charts. First, I will open a chart grid I previously saved. The name of the first is Tech Giants Daily. I open this saved chart layout and look to see in which chart pane I want to place this custom study. I prefer to have mine display in the upper right chart pane. Next, I will show you how to add the custom study to this chart pane. I do this by pressing the Studies button of that chart pane and navigate down to Add Study. I continue to navigate down to User Defined. This pops up a list of custom studies in my library. So I navigate up to the study we just added. It appears in alphabetical order, and the name is Chart Grid Name. I click it, and it is immediately added to this chart pane in the upper right. You can see it gets added with a default text value of My Chart Grid. I will show you now how to modify that text. Pressing the Studies button, I navigate to and click the Edit Studies. I'll move this window over to the left so we can view the chart while we work. Clicking the gear icon opens the Parameters dialog. This first parameter is where we are going to type the name of our chart layout, using the same name we used to save it. Clicking the Help bubble pops up a description of each parameter. So after typing in the name, I think I want to change the color of that text label. I want it to stand out against the white chart background. The actual text of the label will remain unchanged as it gets its color from the background. Be sure to click the Apply and OK to save these changes, and click Apply and OK once more to push those changes to the chart. So you can see it immediately changed the text to Tech Giants Daily, and the color of the label switched to dark. Now don't go anywhere yet. You need to make sure you immediately resave this chart layout. If you don't save, the changes will be lost, and the Thinkorswim platform does not keep track of changes and will not prompt you to save changes if you close or switch to another saved chart layout. This next chart layout has a dark background, and I'm going to perform the same exact steps as before. Clicking Studies, Add Studies, then to User Defined, then navigate up to and click the Chart Grid Name Study to add it to the upper right chart pane. Once again, you can see when it's first added to the chart pane, it displays the default color and text. It is completely agnostic to any other chart this study has been added to. That's what makes this work. Each chart gets its own independent version. Next, I'll click Edit Studies and click the gear icon to access the parameters. I'll type Tech Giants intraday for this chart layout. Even though the default label color is fine for the black background, I'm going to change it to green just to show you how it looks. Be sure to click Apply and OK twice to push these changes out to the chart. Looks pretty good, but what if the green isn't quite right for this chart? I'll open the parameters again and change it to red. Being sure to click Apply and OK twice. But don't go anywhere yet. Remember, this process is not complete until you resave this chart layout. The Thinkorswim platform will not prompt you to save changes, ever. No, I'm serious. Never. Next, let's be sure this actually works. I need to open the first chart layout and make sure those changes were not somehow undone by the previous steps. Eureka! It works! Now we have a way to display the exact name of each chart layout we save on the Thinkorswim platform. Clicking the third button from the left takes us to the flexible grid view. You can see I have numerous saved chart layouts. I'll go through these one by one. I think by now you have all the steps down, so I'll speed up the video here until we get them all set up. Hey, are you watching this? After harping on you about saving your changes, I dropped the ball right here on the first chart layout. Perhaps it's for the best, so you don't forget. Here I show a different way of adding the study to the chart. Pause the video here if you want to catch the details. It's a shortcut. Saves a few clicks of the mouse. I use the same shortcut for the rest of the chart layouts. So if you missed it the first time, you should get a good idea by the end. The shortcut essentially consists of adding the study to the chart directly from the Edit Studies dialog. So you can go straight into the parameters as soon as you add it to the chart. This video is only going at 2x normal speed, so you can see it doesn't take long to implement this workaround. You just need to make sure you don't skip any steps, like I did on the first one. Okay, we're getting down to the end here. When this is complete, I will review each of the chart layouts in order. So you will get to see how the first one failed to take, because I failed to save the changes, but all the rest come out perfect. Here's the one I missed. Threw me for a loop during the headlights here. Kept thinking it was going to show up eventually. So let's try the next one. Ah, there we go. Perfect. Now, let's make sure the rest of them worked. This one is good. Okay, next one. Very good. Now, if we go back to the charts view, you can see what we did in the flexible grid had no impact at all. Completely separate entities. Okay, that's all I've got to show you on this topic. Hope it helps you keep better track of your saved chart layouts until a clearer solution is made available. Thank you for watching this tutorial video. Be sure to visit www.hahn-tech.com for the full library of tutorials. I hope this video increases your knowledge and helps you become more efficient with this topic, whether for home or work. Please support this channel by sharing these videos with your friends and colleagues. Thanks and take care.